It's about the issue of marriage, according to the nations and according to the experts.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's not
enough
to debate. I don't really know about that.
No, it's good. That's a good question. I don't know about that. So if you don't know, you go to the experts.
Yeah.
So this book brings the experts.
That's good. I'll check on it online.
No, shall I? Yeah. The sources here, for example, just give you a sources. Hold this. Just I give you a sources here, which is look. If you go to 26, 27, it's no problem. You say, I don't know. Like, for example, James Ecott, this one of the prophecies, which is one on America, yeah? Not just him, there's many. He speaks about the issue. Frank Fasick writes in his paper on the invention of adolescence for the journal Early Adolescence. So all of these experts speak about this issue. Because look, if you want to speak about physics, you and I, maybe you know a little bit about physics, but you go back to the experts. Yeah. You understand? Yeah. Likewise about biology. Yeah. So when we speak about this issue, because you know, even the in this country, the kings, they were known to get married to a woman at a young age. No, but what is right? What is wrong?
We know what's right and what's wrong.
Okay, show me.
If I go kill someone, that's wrong. Everyone knows it's wrong. It's morally wrong.
But why?
Because the child is not ready for that.
Okay, but in the Bible, the Bible says kill children.
Yeah, didn't God kill children in Allah?
No, but
Allah not kill children.
No, what did you just say?
Did he not join the world?
But listen,
did Allah not join the world?
Listen carefully.
And babies.
You missed the point. Cool, you missed the point.
So
you said
like
killing is wrong.
Who's killing is wrong?
But I told you, if killing is wrong, and the Bible says kill children.
God, when it comes to us killing each other, that's wrong. That's flesh. We're killing each other. And while God, who gives us life, you can take away life.
No. In the Bible, there is a life, kill the Malachite babies. Mm-hmm. So you are humans.
And did you read about why God said that they should do that?
So there is justification for killing.
But didn't God...
So killing not all the time is wrong. That's my point.
At the same time, marrying children is wrong, period.
Okay, what
certain
is...
Certain things that you can't...
No watch. Problem, what is children?
Children, they're little kids. Like,
what?
The age? Kids, and don't put me in a bit.
What age? 35.
I'll say like under 10, under the age of 10.
That's not a child. Google it. Child, a child and an adult. It does, because if you can't call someone child if it's not child.
That's why
okay,
there's a consent in this country, because we know the standard.
Okay, no, sorry. You accept it in this country.
What?
You accept it.
I will not accept it.
Hear me out.
If you had a 5-year-old child.
You had a five-year-old child. No, do you accept this country?
What do you mean? Hold on.
That's what I mean. Do you accept?
If you have a five-year-old child, would you allow?
Before you tell me allow five, do you accept that the law of this country?
I don't know. Yeah, maybe.
You accept? So if the law of this country,
right,
for 100 years,
yeah,
the age of marriage, not this country, worldwide, was the age of 7.
Okay.
So if you live back then, you accept it, correct?
Back then, probably, if that's
how. Do you know why?
Yeah.
Because you know what? I'll tell you why. Do you know why? Let me explain to you why. Come. Explain to you why back in those days, because children were not same as our time. Back in those days, there was no primary school, secondary school, college, university, nursery. No, back in those days, like even I will cite from a non-Islamic look, according to British common law, during the colonial period, the age of consent was 7.
So are you trying to justify?
No, I'm not. Listen.
Are you trying to justify?
Back in those days,
obviously, it's
not now. No, yeah, of course, it's not talking about.
Now.
No, but no.
Things have been abolished.
No, but not even now.
Now.
Even now, I'm not saying it's wrong completely. Do you know why? Because I don't have a mind, mastermind. You know why? Because Asia and Africa, they have different culture.
Yeah.
Who am I to go to them and force my way on them?
Yeah, yeah.
Who am I to tell them the age of consent is 18? If you don't follow my way, you are a pedophile. Who am I? Except if I believe what? I'm European, as I have a slave mastermind.
Yeah. No.
Understand?
Yeah, yeah.
So even our time, like if you go to some Eskimo, what is the age of consent?
I don't know.
11, 12. According to British law,
all around the world.
That's my point.
I understand that.
I can agree on that.
So
I'm saying, anyone that's
the thing
out,
is,
that's what I'm saying.
Is,
yeah.
It's wrong for a prophet. If it's a prophet,
yeah,
someone who has moral
there
standards
go
from God,
yeah,
that's different.
Show,
that
okay,
person's showing an example
from
God.
Show me in the Bible says if the girl is the
age. Listen,
no.
Don't go to the.
Because
we're talking about Muhammad.
Okay. Okay. Prophet Muhammad, according to the law,
yeah,
to Islamic law, and to worldwide law, there was nothing with it. Yeah. I'll give you what here. Let me explain Islamic sources.
Hey, yeah, let us go.
To understand the point though, like morally.
What could you do? You talk about now. I'm talking about 1,000 years ago.
Yeah, you could talk 1,000 years ago. Even then, people even seen
more. Give me one. Said it's wrong. Back
I'll
then.
See that people. Yeah, a lot of people.
Yeah, give me.
Then people marry people that around their ages.
No. That, I don't want your life story. He said he was.
Maybe not just a point. Just maybe it's more because you can argue about the past forever. Maybe it's more relevant to talk about what we should do today.
Exactly. That's the point. Yeah.
Talk about whatever you want.
That's a good point. No, my point here is that people, because they are taking the issue of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam getting married to Aisha from the historical context.
Yeah, I know.
And misusing it.
Right.
Because we have here that is worldwide, like, you know, I can even cite out for you from one of the books that is being used in this country as for those who are interested in the law, in criminal sexual behavior.
Right.
That was worldwide the age of consent 7. Because back in those days, what differentiated a child from a woman, a child girl from a woman, was the age of puberty.
Yeah.
You understand that?
Yeah.
So now, it doesn't make any sense someone say she was a child. Because according to back then, when the girl is age of puberty, she's not a child anymore. You understand? So is that an example? Here in this country, under 16, what is it? Child, correct?
Yeah.
So imagine you go to Africa, say, you know what? You're doing pedophilia. Why? Because you're getting married.
France.
Did I tell you know what? Who are you?
The point you're making, I already agree with these. So I don't understand. All I'm saying is Muhammad, who's meant to be the perfect example.
What would my
and married a 6-year-old?
No.
Because
there's not what is
according to you, according to the best man according to Muhammad.
Okay.
You've asked me like 100 questions.
No, but you said you didn't ask him a question.
Who
not asking my question?
Who's the best man according to Quran?
Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
Right, so marrying a 6-year-old, is that permissible for a Muslim who follows Muhammad?
Engagement.
Right.
No problem at all, engagement.
So,
you know it's engagement?
So,
do you know it's engagement?
Engagement or not, it's still wrong.
No, do you know it's engagement?
You consummated the marriage at 9.
Do you know it's engagement?
Either way, it's still wrong.
He's not asking my question, now I can't debate him.
You're telling me how...
Engagement means, I'll tell you it's engagement.
Marry. Lecture us.
Engagement?
Yeah. No.
Because you are ignorant of the issue.
No, just go ahead.
That's what I think to you. Otherwise, you're not... Engagement meaning that you have, I know you very well, I see you are a righteous man, you have a daughter, and I know you are righteous people, and you know I'm a righteous man, so you say what? Your daughter, I want to give my word to you. When she reach the age of marriage, the age of what? Of marriage. Yes? I will marry her. That's called engagement, giving my word, and you say accept. Then what you have to do according to Islam, you have to wait for her until she's the age of marriage, then you ask her permission first. You see what I'm saying? So the age of marriage, you know, of course,
No,
what country you from?
No, let's stick to
No, I'm asking what country you from?
No.
Do you know why? Because by definition, your ass will be pedophiles.
Okay, alright.
Do you accept ass will be pedophiles?
Let me go back to the point. Muhammad, we said Muhammad is the best example for mankind.
Yeah.
Is it all permissible for, how old was he at the time, like 50?
Yeah.
It's like 50 to marry a 9-year-old, to ask a 9-year-old, to look at a child.
No. That's a wrong statement. You're saying child.
Child.
Let me read.
So she's a woman at 9.
No problem. Let me just look. You said you don't know about this issue, correct?
No, go ahead.
Look, if you are sincere,
yeah.
I gave you the book in the beginning. I said, read. Take it. He said, no. I have no problem with it. But now you see you have problem with it. So let me read out the expert.
So the age of consent was at 9. Just so I get it.
The best thing is to read out to you the... Look here. In past societies, boys became a man and the girls became a woman. Males of all ages grew up with each other and the females of all ages grew up with each other. As a result, children reach mental maturity much earlier because of the sustained constant direct contact with a man and woman who pass on cultural and moral values, as well as involving children in specialized crafts and economics activities from an early age. That how it was back in the days, you understand? And what was the age? It was the age 7 and 8. That's what we have here, the English, what they call them, the English kings, okay?
Look, Shamsi, like, I understand.
Hey, come here out. Mike, okay, Mike knows, American socialist, yes? And a professor at the University of California. So who is an expert in this field?
Okay.
He said this early law specified that girls consenting to sex had to be at least 10 to 12 years old in most states, with a few specifying age as old as 14 or 16. In one of the states of America, the age of consent was 7, based on ancient English law setting the age. Christine Luca writes, according to British law, during the colonial period, the age of consent was 7. Today we are astounded that girls of this age were assumed to know enough about sex or about sin to make such decision.
Right.
So back in those days,
yes,
according to British law,
yeah.
American law,
yeah.
African law,
yeah.
Asian law, the girl, if she's the age of puberty, she what? She's a woman.
Look,
okay? That's my point. Otherwise, what I have to do? You keep to the Prophet Muhammad is the best example.
No, that's the... Okay, listen. Let me just say what I'm saying. Look, listen. Shamsi, I understand what you're saying. I understand that.
Can I remember Mary,
she was 12 years old, yeah.
The age of consent back then was a problem. We understand that.
It was a problem?
Yeah.
According to you?
Okay, it wasn't a problem, but it was normalized. It was a pretty normal thing. We understand that. But Muhammad is the best example.
That's what I was going to say.
Yeah, for like all Muslims.
Yeah?
For everyone. Apparently.
We're women, yeah? Yeah. For everyone, of course, the Bible.
The thing is, like our society nowadays, we've got, we've got a higher standard of morality.
Higher standard, according to who?
But back then.
To secular law.
Because right now, we see a child.
You became atheist.
We see a child, yeah.
You became atheist.
We see a child, that's 10, that's playing with dolls. Like, even Aisha was playing with dolls.
She was 16.
She was a child.
She was 16, no.
Aisha was 16.
Yeah, she was, at that time she was 16.
But you just said she was 16.
Yeah.
No, you missed. You said she was playing with doll. That hadith, she was at the age of 16.
But she's still a child then if she's playing
16.
With dolls.
16? Okay, wait. So, wait.
She's been a child then.
No. Who said if a man or a woman have a doll is a child?
Who said? Okay, listen. It's not even that. Listen.
No, okay, that's what
listen.
I like. I like
Aisha,
Christian
Aisha was six. Aisha was six.
No,
yeah?
Keep talking about Aisha.
Look.
My point here is, give me what is the criteria you are utilizing to determine what is right or is wrong.
I'm telling you. All right, listen. In the Quran, right?
No, I'm asking that. My question, because is the Quran your criteria?
It's not my criteria.
My question, look, let me repeat my question. No. Your criteria, I'm giving you, I'm going to let you come to the garden. What is your criteria to determine what is right, what is wrong?
It's wrong. Everyone will say that. Everyone.
I'm not, you know,
hey, listen.
I don't know how to speak. Waga Nugu, Migi Nugu, Waga.
Okay. What does that mean?
I spoke English. I said to you, what is your criteria you are utilizing to determine what is right, what is wrong?
I said, well, moral. Yeah, exactly.
Who's moral? Which moral?
Humanity.
In Africa, they get married at the age of 12 and 11.
Yes.
Or considered slow, they are pedophiles. Will you call them pedophiles? Look, silence.
In Italy, you can marry the
Italy. Yeah,
it's really
subjective. Exactly, it's subjective.
Ask my question. What is your criteria?
What is my criteria? What do you mean by what is my criteria?
I can help you.
What is your criteria?
Where is your criteria? Morally, to me.
No. Because whatever you're going to look at it,
yes.
If your criteria is not from God, it'll be subjective.
Well, say the Bible. It's the same thing.
Say the Bible.
In the Bible says that when God gave commandment to Moses, he said, keep every woman that slept with a man and keep the little girls for yourself.
Let's say it does say that and it condones it in that situation, right?
It doesn't condone it.
In that situation, right? The difference is that in Christianity, part of the figurehead sort of thing isn't Moses, it would be Jesus, right? Whereas in Islam, your figurehead, the person you follow, is the life of Muhammad, right? So even if the prophet, so David, we know that David sinned with Bathsheba, all these kind of things, we don't say, okay, we follow him, that's an issue for us. If Jesus was the one who was doing it, then that would be a problem. So if you want to find a parallel in Christianity, you have to show where Jesus is doing these kind of things.
That's a good argument.
That's what I'm saying.
So you believe Jesus as God?
Yeah.
Correct. So the God that was telling to kill babies and children, that was Jesus.
point. Yeah, no, I think that's
so, so now the question you asked.
All I'm saying is I don't know the context.
No, no problem. What's your name? What's your name?
I'm Luca.
Luca, nice to meet you. My name's Shamsi. Luca, that's a good point. The Christian always come to us as Jesus, he was all loving, correct? That's what they say.
Yeah.
As a man, yeah. But the problem that you have, you believe Jesus was God. So the question you ask yourself, was Jesus more merciful when he was a man than God, or God was more merciful than Jesus when he became a man?
Neither.
No, it has to be one of them.
Why can't they be equally merciful?
I'll tell you why. Because God has more mercy than human being.
You know what? Wait. Say the whole thing.
Okay.
Again,
Jesus was a man. Okay.
Yeah, no, but that's ignoring the fact that we believe, you know, the whole idea of the hypostatic union.
I understand that there was a God and a man at the same time.
Right, so we're saying that Jesus as God the Son, in his 33 years on life on earth, is equally merciful to his eternity.
He's not, because he said the fact, I tell you what, it's a good point. If you read the Bible, New Testament, yep. He said the Father is greater than I. So that proves that they're not same.
Honestly, I'm not going to lie and say I know the answer to that. Yeah. I have heard good answers to that. I can't remember it.
No problem.
So I can't answer.
I can give you another one.
Did you say the Father's greater than I?
You're in the Bible, Jesus.
Yeah. Did you say, do you want me to say?
Yeah.
Can I say?
It's in John. He said, I'm going to my Father.
Can I say why he said it?
Well, no, you can have
why
it.
He said that? Because he left his deity in heaven and he became a man. He said, the Father's greater, you become a man like you.
Yeah.
The conversation we stopped in
heaven. No.
The conversation we stopped a minute ago is the same conversation. He come like a man like
you. His point, he said, Jesus as God and a man, they were same. So I just told them they were not. That's my point.
Who was the same?
No, Jesus. We said same in terms of mercy.
They're not, because Jesus said the Father is greater than I.
Okay, yeah, and I'm saying is that I have heard answers like to that. I can't remember. I'm not going to pretend.
Okay, I'll give you another one. So my point here is that when Jesus was saying, because you believe Jesus was God, correct?
Yep, yeah.
So when Jesus was telling Moses and telling David to kill the babies, was he merciful that time? Was he still merciful? Because God merciful all the times, correct?
It's complicated because you're saying it's like when God condemns people to hell, for example, right? That's not saying that he then loses his attribute of mercy.
I understand that very well.
He can still have the attribute of mercy, but in that specific example, he's an acting in different attributes.
But he doesn't lose
his mercy. In this instance, he's acting his attribute of wrath or justice.
That's a good point. So therefore, killing the babies and children doesn't remove the mercy of God.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. That's the same.
I'm going off the top of my head.
Right? No, it's true.
The context.
I don't believe God will say kill babies and children, slaughter them. Person might say you don't believe in natural disaster. That's a different subject.
Yeah.
But I don't believe God, because Allah said in the Quran, "Wala taziru wa zatun wizra ukhra." Allah will not punish a baby or a child or a man or a woman for the sins of their forefathers. Allah doesn't do that.
Wait, but why are you presupposing that the killing of the children is necessarily a punishment for sins?
That's a good point, because if you read Samuel, second, 1 from 15, 1 onward, he says, go kill the Malachite. Do you know why?
Kill their
babies and children. Do you know why?
Yeah, because the sins of their forefathers.
That's what I'm saying.
Because
it's not just them. According to you, I believe it's just.
There's a bit of a nuance in that, as far as you can say that he's not telling you that the babies are guilty of the sins of their forefathers, right? He's saying that the sins within the whole Malachite system against Israel is
You can bring that up,
it's
but...
It's to such an extent that it will continue around and they will plague and pollute the surrounding world at the time. So you're saying, wipe them off the map, basically, because they are always going to be a problem of sin going against Israel. And
so you're justifying killing of the babies and children?
I'm going off the top of my head on this. I'm just saying specifically on that scenario, that's what I get.
I'm speaking to him. He's a man of intelligence. So my point is...
You don't want to understand the verse.
Wait 1 minute. So now, I want to take you back to... Forget all of this. Let's go back to the foundation. Look, the reason we believe in Jesus, okay? We believe in Moses. However, we don't believe Jesus was God.
Yeah,
do you know why? Because even in the Quran, Allah said to Prophet Muhammad, if they ask you about the knowledge of the hour, say no one knows it except God.
I know, Matthew 20.
Okay?
Yeah,
but according to Jesus, he doesn't know the hour.
No one knows it.
Because he's left his deity in heaven. He left his form on earth.
So you just said he was God in the man's same time.
You won't accept it.
Okay, wait, he left he God.
Become a man like you.
I'm not trying to.
Exactly like
Aisha. No, Aisha, look, I have many books here. I can give you this book to read. It's a very nice book. here gives the difference between the marriage of King Richard II of England, died 1400 to 6 years old, Isabella, and the King John.
But this still comes back to the central issue, and I think he was bringing it up, was the fact that
Prophet Muhammad is the best example.
Yeah, if King Richard was never, is never seen as
that's a good point. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look, there's two things a Christian they keep mixing. Not everything Prophet Muhammad did, we have to follow. Some things he did was according to his culture. For example, Prophet Muhammad covered his head with the turban, correct? Do I cover my head? No, because the scholar said him not.
Yeah.
Because scholar said that was according to the culture. No one Christian, the Christians that never come to me, say, Shamsi, why don't you get married to a woman? She's 45 and you are 20. Prophet Muhammad did it.
Yeah.
Prophet Muhammad got married to Sauda, she was 50 years old. Why? They don't ask me.
Why?
Because why? Prophet Muhammad's actions, not every action he did was for us to follow. Best example in divine law. In his law and everything. But even in the culture. Mm-hmm. That, for example, my person might say, I want to marry a woman, she's at the age of 10 or 9, okay?
Yeah.
Person might say, no, in Britain, it's pedophilia. Hold on a minute, mate. You're not my slave master. You're not a superior than me. That's according to your law. I'm not British. I'm from Africa. I'm from Asia. I'm from Eskimo. That's why, look, Islam doesn't come and impose this.
The Arab,
in Islam,
I'm speaking to you. Seven or they give you five?
Okay. So my point here is that what is good about Islam, you know, if everyone follow British law, the world become what? Kiosk. Because every...
Kiosk forever, bro. It's been kiosk forever. The whole world.
You know why? Because everyone, every society function according to its culture. Understand? So Islam teach you that sometimes your culture can be part...
It's wrong.
Can you move aside if you don't mind?
I got two.
You know, I'm speaking to you. If you move aside, you can speak.
No,
he's going to speak.
Don't let anyone talk. Just 2 points I want to raise. When you were saying about how Muslims don't have to follow everything that Muhammad did,
yes.
Well, I don't want to go into it, but I just want to bring it up.
Yeah.
If you can answer it.
No problem. If I know, I'll answer it. If I don't know, I don't know.
So, I see a lot of Muslims who, you know, they might grow their beard in a specific way, wear a certain attire and everything, like following the Sunnah of Muhammad as well, like, as much as possible, right?
Yeah.
So, on what criteria are you going to say, okay, him marrying a 45 or a 9-year-old or whatever, that is not part of his Sunnah directly, but this wearing and this exact pattern of
that's good.
That is, how do you differentiate clearly?
Prophet Muhammad gave us a commandment to grow our beard, clearly. So, grow a beard.
Okay.
But Prophet Muhammad never gave us a commandment to marry this age or that age. You know why? Because in the Quran, they give us the age of marriage.
Yep.
And it's up to you when I get married or not. Even Prophet Muhammad doesn't even say you have to get married.
Okay, fine.
Understand?
I accept that. I haven't finished.
No, but I haven't finished.
Okay, fine.
Can I say one thing?
No, I'm speaking to you.
And now you give yourself five, seven women, and give you five. Do you not think that was a bit greedy of him?
That's what we ignore.
But
that, you know, it's the truth.
Sorry, forgive me. Okay, if 10 women came now, they are adults.
But he only gives himself seven in heaven. He's more privileged than you.
He asked me questions, even let me answer. Look at this. If 10 women are adults, and they are mature and everything, and they want to be my wife, and I accept them, why is wrong?
If they're babies, it's wrong process.
I said they're adults.
Little kids.
If they are 50 years old.
If they're adults, that's up to you. That's your prerogative.
So, don't go.
Your wife's if you
want. I said you have to look at Muhammad. You guys are finished, he doesn't know. You guys are finished. But they don't know to have girlfriends. Anyway, Allah give us criteria. The age of marriage. What is the age of marriage according to Quran? But it's not compulsory upon every society. It's the age of puberty.
Okay.
Because why? Even if you go to, if you Google it, what is the difference between a child and an adult? When a child reaches the age of puberty, becomes an adult.
Okay.
However, Islam, in Islam, that is not enough. Why? She has to be what? Psychologically ready.
Okay.
And mature ready.
Okay. So on that point now, so I think you answered that first objection first.
Now I have to check the time for prayer, to be honest, because we pray. You know. It's 4:20. Go on, the last one.
Okay.
Because I need to go pray.
So on the issue of you saying. the only way I can see it being consistent within Islamic theology for Muhammad to marry Aisha is if you're saying at not necessarily the age of 6, but I think it's maybe the age of 9.
Nine,
that she's already reached puberty, and also that she's psychologically mature.
She was mature.
And one potential objection to that is what he raised earlier. You know, he said she was playing with dolls, and you said that was up to the age of 16.
Yeah.
So if she's still playing with dolls up to the age of 16, that is probably indicative of the fact that she's probably not, if she's still in a psychological state where she's still playing with dolls, she's probably not in a psychological state where she's ready with for a marriage 7 years earlier than that even.
Okay.
With Muhammad.
So that's a good point.
That was one point, but the other point was also, you have to substantiate also that she was reached puberty by the age of 9.
She said that.
Those 2 points.
She said, Aisha mentioned herself, she said when a girl reached the age of 9, she's a woman.
But how does that?
So that's what I'm saying. How different between a girl and a woman? The age of puberty.
So
she said that, yeah.
So is that Quran or Hadith?
It's Hadith. Right. Aisha said it herself.
Okay, and is that directly, the way how you're saying woman, right?
Yeah.
Is it very, very commonplace that you guys associate woman with puberty sort of thing?
Yeah, child doesn't call woman in Islam. Okay. You don't call mar'a. Mar'a, you don't call a child a mar'a. You call a bint, a tifla. But not a mar'a, a woman, okay? The other thing which, so you mentioned the toys. What I will tell you, use of Google. Now there is many women in YouTube, big women.
Yeah.
They have the habit of playing with those. Guess what? They are married. Guess what? One of the even she said, my boyfriend, the new boyfriend, he lets me play with those. If she's still child, the government should hand them down.
Wait, but that's different. That's different.
Why? You just told me the doll.
No.
So the doll doesn't make you child.
No. I'm saying, no, but here's the difference. Is that the government, the English British government, they're not operating on a system of Islamic theology and understanding.
No, but I'm saying, according to which law, or according to which criteria, that if a woman plays with a doll, she's a child. Which culture?
On your culture?
No, it doesn't.
Can I explain why? Right.
I told you it doesn't mean that.
I'm trying to explain why, okay. I think it could be. Because you were saying that the two criteria were puberty and psychological readiness, right?
Yeah.
I'm saying that having those pistol playing with those toys is indicative of psychological unreadiness.
According to you.
The whole thing is subjective.
He just gave an example.
I know. Relate to that example.
You are not connected.
The problem is that we have no 10-year-old children here. Okay. If they were here,
we don't have 10 years old of 1,400 years ago. That's it.
I don't know if it makes a difference.
Well, it does, because according to experts,
verse anyway.
You can read the book here.
My hands are closed.
I have read the book. The knowledge is good.
When you brought the example, the adult.
Anyway, keep the book for you.
When you said about the adult, she was old enough.